off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Fielded at the 9. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Fires out to his wideout. And he's tackled at the 45.
I'll tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
Scrambling around. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 45. They get nice yardage on that run. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers. Able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Now he tries to buy some time.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Room around the corner. Good outside run there. So the tailback's going to come away with a first down on the play.
He took advantage of a powerful effort by his offensive line to turn that into a pretty big run.
And that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball, and it comes out a little wobbly.
Second and 10. Ball on the 35. Slings it. And they push him out at about the 43-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Tackles him hard at the 39.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
He's tackled at the 35-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Five wide. Big opening. And they make the stop at the 44.
tackle made at about the 37-yard line.
That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
There's a strike complete.
Tackle around the 28-yard line.
Hands off to the right and is brought down in the backfield.
Decision making. He sees it opening, decides to turn it upfield, and gets a nice gain and a first down.
Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down
around the 9-yard line.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. This is the eighth play of this drive.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
It's third down, and they come up to the line about 9 yards away from the end zone. Here comes the pressure. Oh, it almost picked off. Kentucky could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the three. And down he goes at the 28.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Nice run, and he's brought down. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And down he goes at the 37. The pitch, and now the ball is free. Now the quarterback has the ball, and they'll get him in the backfield. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He makes it to the 45-yard line. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defenses, but I think you're going to see both these offense coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play call.
We're set to get restarted as the offense looks to build on the success of their field goal on the last drive.
Gets it out quickly, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line.
Looks like we're going to have a good game on our hands. After one, 3-0, Wildcats.
And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Tight end right. Four down, four down.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's on the run. Makes it out to about the 20. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Kentucky is up a field goal. Fires to his tight end. Nothing doing. From the 20-yard line, second down. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Gives it up the gut. Brought down at the 9-yard line. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
That brings him second and goal.
Tackled for a loss.
The way the safety was playing up towards the line of scrimmage shows you what they think of the offense's passing game. Not a lot of respect for it.
From the 12-yard line, it's third down. Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he tacks on the extra point. A nice 7-play, 44-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Looking for the corner. He makes it to the 35-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's on the run. He's tackled around the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down.
Best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
First and 10, ball on the 46-yard line. He's taken down at the 42-yard line.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Fires to the wideout, first down. And he's tackled at about the 27-yard line.
That's the kind of rangy flanker every quarterback wants to be throwing to. He did well to make sure he had enough yardage to pick up the first down.
From the 27-yard line, it's first down. Here they come. Quick throw. Knocked out of bounds around the 20-yard line. zips it out to the right.
And here's another third down. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. The wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Throws to the tailback, incomplete. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. Think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. The wide receiver wasn't able to hang on.
Well, you talk about a solid hit. This guy is a true enforcer.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 29. That's a deep one. Mike 50, Mike 50. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Just like a play-action pass relies on the defense respecting the run, a delay relies on the defense respecting the pass.
Scrambled, and they make the stop around the 35-yard line, and they get stopped after a short gain.
Yeah, the quarterback better get these guys to the line of scrimmage and hurry up.
From their own 35-yard line, second down. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. Tackle in space. Wow, a long game, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
It's a short kick, and he muffed it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36.
He was definitely peeking to see what kind of space he had to run. And that loss of focus is what cost him.
Well, at least for now, the crisis was averted, and they keep control of the ball. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Pass right, running back's got it. He's knocked down a bounds around the 42-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He lets it fly. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Tackle made at the 25.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Hit immediately. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Second and 9 coming up here. Ball on 24. Now he's scrambling, and he's going to come up with a sack. That
That's a three-yard pickup.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
So they're going to go for it here. Out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. We've played a half of football here. Kentucky's got a 10-point lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Chris Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick. You know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know. Do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Got the corner. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line. Wildcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Quick out to his receiver. And they hit him in the backfield. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 35. Hauls that one in. Excellent open field tackle. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Tackle right around the 32-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 23. He airs it out. They'll bring him down at the 3-yard line. First and goal from the 2, and they can smell the end zone.
Watch the curls. Watch the curls. Hey, Mike 40, Mike Touchdown, Eastern Michigan.
It takes a lot of strength to run it when you're heading into a massive pile of bodies. Good job of holding on to it and getting it across the goal line.
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he hits the PAT. So a six-play, 65-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute in the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you can move the ball down the field.
He makes it to the 28-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Kentucky has a three-point lead. Here's a quick throw. Almost intercepted.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 41. In the shotgun and five wideouts. He's out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
It could be that the offensive coordinator is trying to lure the secondary in to play more press coverage. And then they'll try to take advantage by going deep. Those safeties better be ready.
Just throws this one away. It. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 29. To the receiver, incomplete.
Number two, he takes a receiver on the way. That'll make it third and 13.
We got man. Mike 40, Mike 40, just take his seven.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and they push him out at the 45.
If you're the defense coordinator, you got to be frustrated with the way your defense gave up that first down. The defense has got to do a better job of recognizing the screen and then chasing it down from behind, especially the defensive linemen. They've got to see whether it's the quarterback or the offensive lineman to tip the screen and then help the rest of the defense be able to slow that play down and not give up that first down.
From their own 45-yard line, first down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Down at the 49-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45.
Right.
complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes at the 37. It to the 27. And this is the eighth play of the drive. They bring him down in the backfield.
Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has the confidence in his own athletic ability to be able to make that safety miss and get upfield for some yards. That time, the safety just dominated him, made a great tackle in the backfield for a short loss.
They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Tackle around the 16-yard line.
That's a deep attempt. That brings up second and one.
We're headed to the fourth quarter, and both of these defenses are still stealing the show. The Wildcats lead 10-7. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He's taken down at the 14-yard line. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Taken down right around the 4-yard line. First down. They've got four cracks at it inside the five. It's first and goal. And he's tackled at the 4. Here's play number 14 of this drive.
Call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Eastern Michigan is ready to kick it away. He really got a hold of that kick. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Quick pass. And they make the stop around the 26-yard line. And has a first down. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
That's a 55-50.
Let's go!
Easy, easy, easy! Let's go!
fights forward to about the 39. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Tackle made around the 46-yard line. He makes it to the 48-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 48-yard line. Second down. Just under three to go in regulation. The 45. Fires out to his wideout, and he tackles him hard at the 36-yard line. It to the right. Caught. Tackle around the 11-yard line. Touchdown! And that puts them on top. That was a well-drawn up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the 9. Tackle at the 24-yard line. Eastern Michigan's given them all they can handle today, and they're still not done.
Yeah, let's remember, they were a heavy underdog coming into this game, and here they are, under 3 minutes to go, with the football, a chance to put a drive together, and who knows, maybe they can take the lead.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Gets out to around the 32. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Just under two to go in the game. Looking for his man, incomplete.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. Third and long in the fourth quarter. If the defense gets a stop here, it might be a W. He's out of bounds. So they keep the sticks moving on third down.
That was a great play. They still have a long way to go, though, Brad.
Quick strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down at the 28. From the 28-yard line, it's first down. Scrambling around. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Diving for extra yardage. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Coming, baby.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 16. Brought down at the 6-yard line. The Eagles will use their first time out of the half. 10th play of the drive. Under a minute left in the game. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. Big kick here. This would most likely bring the game to overtime. A miss, and this game is over. And it's through the uprights. Eastern Michigan, ready to kick this one off.
Number 15, deep to return.
He'll return it from the 3. Across the 30. He's tackled at the 31-yard line.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. He's on the run. He dives, and he'll be marked down. Goes a laser across the middle, and he is drilled at the 37-yard line. Right, picked off.
It was time for somebody to step up and make a play, and boy, did the defense come through. Now they've got a chance to take the lead. That was huge.
We've got a first and 10, ball on the 24. Screen pass, he's got his halfback. And down he goes at the 24. He scrambled. Slides down to the ground. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. And here we are. We played four quarters, and we still don't have a winner, so we go to overtime. Tries to buy some time, and he's sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 26. Hit and taken down. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
The 5-yard line. That's good for 3 yards. That brings him second and goal.
This is from the 5-yard line. It's third and goal. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 6-yard line. And the kicker comes out to try to put 3 points on the board here in overtime. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. Screen. Big play, and it's first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
You don't think these guys get aggressive when it counts? Terrific hit to prevent the score.
From the 4-yard line, it's second down. This one is over.
Well, both teams have been fighting hard the entire game, and it just gets tougher in overtime. These guys deserve a world of credit for pulling this one out because it's been a real battle.
And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, Kentucky 23, Eastern Michigan 20. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.